Say some good words to you good people. I know a lot of you traveled from a long ways to be here with an open heart and with an open mind, open spirit, and that's what it's all about. So on a count of three, I want you to give a warm welcome to Grandmother Beatrice. 1, 2, 3!
Miigwech. Miigwech in our language, it means I hold what you give me with the deepest respect. So for you saying what you just did, I say it back to you, Miigwech. Thank you, Miigwech. This morning we met at the sacred stone and we prayed, we lifted our pipes, we smudged, we sang the calling on the spirit song. And we recounted the creation story. I don't know if any of you were there for the creation story. Was anyone there?
Moonrise, yeah.
What was the first fire of creation?
Sound.
Like what? Like the drum. And also that feeling sound that came from the shaker, which were the thoughts of our Creator going into the universe. And then since it was darkness, what was the next fire of creation? Grandfather's son. He came and he's blessing us today. And what is the third fire of creation? Grandmother Moon. Because there is equality in that spirit realm as it is here between the female and the male. And they go in a sacred circle. And the next fire of creation was movement, so that we would go into that sacred circle like our grandfather sun and grandmother moon. And in that sacred circle we have the four directions, we have the four races of people, we have all those four medicines, we have all those teachings about the creation of our world, and the Creator is thinking of us at that time. And after the movement, what came next? What was the next fire of creation? You remember the children? What was the next fire of creation? The creation of the birds. Let me hear the birds. The birds of every color, of every size. And those birds brought the sacred seeds, like the seeds in a gourd. Over here, closer. Like the seeds in a gourd. So these are our sacred objects. And the drum. And the bird beings were flying around, and they said, why must we fly around? Where are we going to be? And the Creator then thought, he's going to create the most beautiful spirit, the most beautiful spirit that we call Gula Ache Sakmakwaya, our Mother the Earth. And the Creator took medicines from all the stars and the planets, and he put them together. And with the Miga shell, he blew life into our Mother the Earth. And she was so beautiful when she was so young. And water was around her and covered her. And she was very happy. And the Creator looked at her and he said, there is nothing more beautiful than our Mother the Earth. And he cried. And when he cried, that became our first raindrops, the first drops of rain. And upon Mother Earth was the water, and all the beings that came from the water, came all the crawling ones, came all the four-legged ones, came all the creatures of the earth, even the trees, even the rocks, even the breath, even the fire. All these things came to be because of the Creator's infinite love for us. And then thought the Creator, I must create beings to talk with. And so from the eastern, from the northern direction, he created a being from that northern direction. And then he faced the next direction in the east. He created a being in the east and in the west and in the north, the south, all these directions. And he said, I want to ask you, will you take care of our mother? Will you give thanks to her every day? Will you honor her? Will you love her? And all those beings said they would. They said, but you must do it all the time. Will you do it? And then will you come here into the earth and do your work? The man from the north in Europe, yes, I will. the men from the West and Africa and those areas. Will you do my work? Yes, I will. All those beings were in unity with that. And he asked the red man, will you do my work? And he said, no. Why? Why? Because I'm small. I'm insignificant. I don't have wings to fly. I do not have fur. I do not have the strength of the buffalo. I do not have the cunningness of the maingan, of the wolf. I do not have these things. I need help. So in creation, that was created. So can I hear from the wolves? Very good. Let me hear from the birds. Can I hear from any of the tall beings? Those ones known as Sasquatch. He's watching us now. All those beings were created and must be respected. The tiniest ones to the largest ones. So then he asked First Man, where is First Man? Where's Waywana? Where's that young man, Waywana? So these beings, he asked him, he says, now will you do my work? He says, no, I will not. Why? Because you're going to be talking to me. You're going to come into my dreams, and I do not know how to talk back to you. And so the Creator created upon the earth a sacred plant known as tobacco. He said, use that tobacco, and I will hear your prayers. Now will you come to earth? Now will you come to earth? And First Man Waywana said, yes, I will do that. And as he's coming to earth, he can't do it because there's so much water around. He said, I need help. I need help. And a great whale said, jump on my back. I will carry you to our mother. And he came all that ways. And he said, oh, stop. He said, I can't go any further. I'll be beached. I'll be killed. I need help. And a great sea turtle came. He says, get on my back. I will take you in. So the sea turtle tried his best. He's trying to navigate the waters. I need help. And so he asked the sturgeon, the great 20-foot sturgeon, and they flanked him, and they brought him to our mother, the earth. And he's looking upon the earth, just as you're standing there. He said, earth is so beautiful. I do not want to harm a blade of grass. So on his tiptoes, he fell to earth, and where he stepped grew sweetgrass. And sweetgrass to this day is our sacred medicine. So this man was told, I want you to do everything, Waywana, everything exactly and precisely correct. Do as good as you can every day. And when the Creator calls you home, say, I did my best. And that was First Man's duty, to name everyone. So we had a young boy that we had to represent that Waywana Bujol. And every one of the people, they said, we have a name, Maingan, wolves, where are you? Bird beings, eagles, cranes, all of you have names. And he said, why don't I have a name? And the people looked around. Where is that perfect man who does everything correct? Waywana Bujol? Are you Waywana Bujol? Waywana Bujol? Are you Waywana Bujol? And they said, no. And suddenly out of the mist comes that first man. I am Waywana Bujol. So to this day, Anishinaabe people, they might say Bujol to you. Or when you do something good, they will say Waywana. But that is the story of our first human beings that walked the earth. So when we prayed this morning, we prayed from the four directions. We prayed about unity. We prayed about respect. We prayed about loving our earth mother and loving our water. We prayed about the respect for women. What I'm wearing today is a beautiful piece of beadwork. This was created in the time of greasy grass. This was created in the time of Sitting Bull. And the women made this piece of beadwork. And they said, brother, father, uncle, we know you're going to do something good. You're going to protect us so we will not be moved. And so the women gave of their flesh and had it cut from their bodies and made into a shaker. And Sitting Bull used that shaker when he prayed, when he fasted for our people in the most beautiful way. But who was it that gave strength to our men It is our women. So the woman next to you, look at her and thank her. Say miigwech. Say miigwech to our women and protect and love them. Take care of them. And for our singers here, we have our beautiful man here, all the ones I've heard all weekend singing most beautiful songs of thanks, of loving, of songs of creation. This comes from up above, a gift from the bird beams, a gift from our drums, a gift from our shakers, a gift from everything that's sacred. Where you walk upon this earth is sacred, this beautiful grass, the beautiful waters, seeing our children play. And we have to take care of those children. Don't let them get lost. We must protect our land. And Sitting Bull said, I will not be moved. And they tried to move the Lakota. And there was one woman there. She says, I will not be moved. And she put her baby on her back. And she began walking. And as she walked, she turned to stone. And when you go to South Dakota, when you go there, you will see that sacred stone with a bust of Sitting Bull, and it said, we shall not be moved. And everyone tried to take those sacred stones. He said, that sacred stone woman, she stays here. She stays here in this area. She stays here at Standing Rock. Our people will not be moved. And we will do our work. We will give love. We will give respect. We will give thanks to our singers, our drummers, all of our people that have helped make Pyro what it is. I only have those few words to give you, except my love. I give you my love and I give you my thanks. And we're going to be a little bit of time tomorrow over at the Sacred Stone. But we're going to be back here June 9th, and I hope you will join us for the next Pyro. Because Joe and Gina and Superman and all these ones have been praying hard that we have the right to gather. We have the right to sing. We have the right to dance. We have the right to wear whatever the heck we want to wear. We have that right. We are children of our Creator. So I thank you very much for kindly listening to me and listening to an older woman. I really love you and I respect you, and thank you for always saying hi to me. And thank you for that most brilliant introduction from my nephew here, this most beautiful one. So I thank you, and say miigwech. And we say in our language, we're all related. Nikena kana. Nikena kana. Nikena kana. Nikeni kana. Nikeni kana. And one question. What is life?
Water.
What is life?
Water.
Water is life. What is life?
Water.
In the language, Miniwachoni. Water is life. Thank you. I turn this back over to my nephew. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.